Hello Jan, you're not on the highway. How come?
Things have changed. Since actually COVID-19 put us all in lockdown, I'm traveling a lot less. Before, I used to be in Zagreb at least 3 days a week, usually from Tuesdays until Thursdays. But nowadays, we're doing mostly all of our work remotely. So for me nowadays, it's more often the home office.
Is it a myth that Janša was called after you?
Oh, that's probably something that I made up myself, because I once made a LinkedIn post where I said that it was an honor that they called this gas station after me because I'm visiting it so often. But I think that Janša was already there way before I came to Croatia. So, but it is my favorite stop when I go from Split to Zagreb. Then I cannot skip Janša.
Balance your private and business life?
It's not so much balanced, I would say. It's a constant blending in between from business and private. I mean, I work from home whenever there's something happening in the house with the kids. Of course, I'm there to be there and to help out. So it's very dynamic. But speaking of energy, one thing that I in particular do is I pay close attention to what I eat. So we're actually very often on a food program called Wall 30, where we avoid eating gluten and dairy products, no alcohol for certain periods of time. And you know, at the end of the day, the food is the fuel for your body. And if you put in the wrong fuel, then your body can't perform. So we try to be careful with what we eat.
If you had to tell your children only one business advice, what would it be?
Perhaps it's going to sound a little bit cliche, but I think that you should always follow your passion, because life is too short to be working a job that you don't enjoy. And at the end of the day, I think that if you really follow your passion and if you do something that you truly enjoy, then I think there's always a way to make money with that.
Do you have political ambitions?
No, I don't. I personally think that actually this country will move forward as a result of entrepreneurial efforts. And you know, a great example of that, for example, is that like 6 months ago, I started an initiative where I asked the Prime Minister in an open letter on LinkedIn if he would be so kind to introduce a digital nomad visa in Croatia. 6 months later, actually, we have managed to change two laws. One of them being that digital nomads will be able to stay in Croatia all the way up till 12 months. So these are remote workers from all around the world that will be able to stay in Croatia up till 12 months, during which they will not have to pay any income tax in Croatia in order to avoid double taxation. And this opens up a lot of entrepreneurial opportunities for people here, because now with these new laws in place, I believe that we can turn Croatia into a year-round destination, and that is going to result in a lot of new business opportunities for this country.